Have had the opportunity to see the study that he was talking about, the interior exterior tax study. Basically what we did here was we took the hallway and the bedroom out of that study and we were able to build them. We found so much from that study just with those two components that we felt it important to actually build these and be able to show you a lot of what we found in the study. What we're going to go over is water mapping, where your water goes, and air entrainment. So when we did the study, those were the first two components of the study. We initially wanted to say, where does our water go? We spray it up into dark smoke, hot environment, and we think it has this effect, but we've never really measured it. We don't really know. A lot of the books explained to us, it acts as a sprinkler. You hit it off the ceiling, it creates a sprinkler effect and coats everything in the room. Well, if that's the case, urinals would not be invented because you would wet everything around you. We've all known for a long time, if you've ever used a urinal, females, sorry, you haven't.
That you know.
The water hits a surface and rides it. If we've washed off the deck out in front of the apparatus, it doesn't jump up and take a leap, right? It washes and it runs the ground. That's the same thing that happens here. So all this idea that we had where it hits the ceiling and then just goes down and creates a sprinkler, that's not what happens. So we began to see how water application and improper water application has led to a lot of the problems, especially when you start talking about transitional tack, a lot of the reasons why we watch video after video and realize it's not working. Why isn't it working? Because we know the effect that it can have. Why isn't it working? You're going to clearly see when we start putting water through this window and doing different things with this, you're going to clearly see why this is not being successful. You're going to see just how limited you are and how much water and where you're getting it when you don't have the proper angles. We talked in my class, you guys weren't a part of it, we talked in my class about pushing fire. Can you push fire? Yes, you can push fire. There are situations where you can't, but you can push fire, and this done incorrectly will push products of combustion, heat, smoke, all of this into other areas of the house if you have an opening somewhere. I will show you how improperly done you'll move those streamers over there, and thankfully we got a decent wind so you should be able to see it. We'll also do a fog. I'll show you the power of a fog. So when you're using a straight stream or a smooth bore, you're moving roughly 1,000 to 1,200 CFMs. Okay, when you start moving that straight streamer smooth bore around in an O, you start getting up into 2 to 4. When you do a straight stream fog, fog, you open it up, not moving it, you're getting up into the 4,000 to 6,000 CFM range. When you start moving that around, you're getting into the 12,000 to 15,000 CFM range, depending on the PSI of that nozzle. Do you know what 12,000 CFM equates to? Put that in perspective for people. What's your fans? Do you know what your PPV fans are? We run in Prince George's County, all our trucks are staffed with BH20s, our blowhard, 20-inch blowhard fans. That's 10,200 CFMs. And with a fog nozzle on a straight, less than a 30, you're moving 12 to 15,000 CFM. You're moving more than a blowhard fan. So it's a very powerful tool. And done incorrectly, it can create hazardous results. So what we're gonna do is, I'm gonna show you, first, we're gonna take a look at where does the water go. I'm gonna show you very, very low angle, and you're gonna see just exactly how little coverage you're actually getting. When you do a transitional tacker, when you apply water even from the inside, you're going to want to get as much coverage of that room, because when you get as much coverage of that room, you're taking that fuel, or you're taking that ventilation limited fire that has two components to it, the gases are so hot that the actual air's on fire. That's what flashover is. It's heating all of those contents up, keeping that process going. When you coat all of those surfaces, you knock the gases out. Once you've knocked the gases out, you take that fire back down to just the fuel, just the contents. We can manage contents, that's pretty easy. So when you apply water from a hallway into a bedroom, or you apply water from the outside to the inside, it's about taking those gases out, knocking them out, but you have to get as much coverage as possible, and I'm gonna show you. Can I get a volunteer? Go ahead. If we can, get that line out, around, and pointed up here.
Hold on, guys, hold on.
Hold!
All right.
So this is a one story, right? So if you're at a one story and you got fire coming out of this window, where do you think you would position the line to start putting water into this window? Anybody just point, where you think? You think here? This be good? You got fire coming out of this window. Do you want to be about right here?
Yeah.
Let's try it. Come right up here. All right, open that line. And hit just below the ceiling, hit the ceiling. How much of that room is actually in water? Very little. Stands out like a pizza slice. When you take this approach, it looks good, right? You want to stay back from the flames. You're thinking, well, I don't want to get too close. But you can see that water was not getting anywhere but that back wall, and maybe not even all of that back wall. One of the other issues we ran into, and we've got a brave soul in there that wants to do this. Do not hit Chris. One of the issues we found with this was, especially this, was you're not affecting fire in the center of the room. While it looks like everything in there is churning around, and yes, he's going to get wet, he is not getting wet enough that would be put out if he was the fire. So go ahead. I'm going to hit Chris. Don't hit Chris. Go ahead.
Right next to the window?
Do the same thing. Hit it right off. So, what we found was, you have a mattress on fire, you have these other contents in the center of the room that's on fire, you're not affecting them. So what we found was, if you get closer, see, he's not even soaked. All right, go ahead and move up to about here. Okay. Now, you're gonna wanna get it pretty steep, all right? Now, obviously we wouldn't be necessarily this close. You got fire coming out of this window, so back up just a little bit.
Thanks, y'all.
All right, so right here, you'll see the difference in the coverage of water just by getting a little bit closer and having a little bit steeper angle. So go ahead, you want your stream to just be under this ceiling, okay, to the top. Now, this is a single story. If you've got a two story, go ahead and move up now. Now you can get a little bit closer, right? We got a lot more wet that time. So now we can get a little bit closer. You're gonna see the steeper the angle, the more the coverage. You're gonna get a lot more water on this front wall now. A lot more on the side walls, and you're still getting the back wall. Go ahead and do it now. You guys see the difference in the coverage? Now we can look at some of these videos, we can look at some of these experiences that people had doing a transitional attack, and we can say, Well, I see why they weren't so successful with that. Their angle was so far off that they were only getting a little bit of water in that compartment cooling one area of that. If they would have had a steeper angle, maybe that would have been a more successful operation. When we looked at the fact that even with that steep angle, we still couldn't put the fire out in the center of the room, we thought, well, what could we do? Well, what's happening is that water's hitting the ceiling with velocity and it's running it. And we said, well, what if we had something that didn't continue on, like a ceiling? What if we could hit a surface that stops? Would it start to fall off right away? It ended up, that's exactly what it did. When we started to do a lintel hit, we call it the lintel hit. When you hit the top of the window, that takes that water and it doesn't have a surface to run now. So it starts dropping. We were able to finally affect that fire in the center of the room. So, if you guys are doing steps on a transitional attack, get the steepest angle you can, safely, right? First floor is gonna be a little challenging. Second floor, when you start getting to third floor fires, you start doing transitional attack on third floor fires. For those of you in my class and those of you that listened yesterday about droplets and air movement, what do you think a problem is on a third floor fire or greater trying to do a transitional attack? Air entrainment. What's happening to your stream at 30 feet? It fans out. It's got more, it's broken up. The more broken up, the more air. When you start bringing air into this, that's when you start pushing fire. When you do a straight stream or a smooth pour with, you can move it, but don't do this. Don't move it around. You can do some movement. When you do that, you are not moving much air at all. Certainly not enough to cause any problems. What else is happening in this structure that they don't tell us about in our books is, does everybody know how much time, how many times steam expands?
1700.
Everybody knows 1700, right? Has anybody, raise a hands other than the person that I was talking to, heard of atmospheric contraction? Thank you, Chief. Nobody, right? They don't tell us about that, but we know about it. Why? Your bottle of water got hot. You don't want to drink hot water. You throw it in a cooler. You come back 30 minutes later. What does your bottle look like and feel like? It's all crinkled up, right? You don't think nothing of it. As soon as you take the lid off, it pops back out. It's equalized. What happened was, when that cooled, it contracted, and it contracted enough to pull your bottle in. That's what's happening in here.
Look for these great steam expansions by applying water, either inside or outside. We're looking for this great steam expansion, right?
But they don't tell us that if we cool something so rapidly it doesn't expand, it actually contracts. To solidify this, when we did one of the studies, we had fire coming out of the window when we did the transitional attack, and we knew how much that air that moved. When we did it, fire stopped coming out, and everything started getting pulled into this room. Everything. No more fire, no more smoke, nothing was coming out of this window, it was all getting sucked in. When I went back and looked at the data, I was expecting to see flow go out the hallway, down the hallway, out into the rest of the house. I actually saw the opposite. I saw air being pulled into that room from the hallway. So air was being pulled in from where we were, and air was being pulled into the room from the hallway. That's how powerful contraction is when done right. When you get into trouble doing this, inside or outside, is when you are using a fog nozzle that is not carrying as much cooling ability as you need, but is bringing a lot of air with it. When your air outweighs your cooling, that's a problem. That's where we run into bad situations. That's really when we can push a lot of fire. So, what we will get into now is, I'll show you just by moving the line around about, well, we'll do the lintel hit. And then I'll show you by moving the line around with the streamers how we can start moving air. We'll go ahead and, where's that tip at?
Fog?
The fog tip. What about that one? You want to spin that off for
me? Hey, you want the 50 at 160? It's right here too.
If you have that, yeah, we'll take that. That way nothing. Now, just a quick preface on this. This has no fire in it, right? I just explained to you about contraction. You're going to see air in, air out, one for one. That is not necessarily how it goes in the real world, okay? Because we have a component that we can't replicate in here. So when you start seeing those streamers going out, when I said that that doesn't move enough air, that's because the littlest amount of air that goes into this thing is gonna come out of this thing, when in reality, you'd be knocking down a fire in this room. So what we're gonna do is, what I want you to do is, if you wanna still be a participant, we're gonna get up here. You're gonna start flowing water. Actually, Ray, should we do the go far and come back? Yeah. Before we do the air, let's do that. Just to show you. So go ahead and come right up there. That's perfect. You're gonna start there, and then you're just gonna slowly start to work back until you get here. And then hit the lintel. All right. Beautiful. So, even with the lentil hit, it still propelled the water pretty far. What do you think that we could do about that? What do you think we could do about not propelling the water so far? It's moving because of velocity, right? What?
Adjust the bale.
Adjust the bale. Can you do that on smooth bore? In this situation, you want to be careful doing that with a smooth bore. Why? Air entrainment. When you start choking down a smooth bore, you break up that stream. This is not a pitch for straight stream or fog or anything. This is just to be aware. If you hear, hey, you could choke down the bale to stop the velocity, but you have a smooth bore, that's not a good idea. So, with a straight stream though, go ahead and do the bale just a quarter of the way up. Just right at the lintel.
Dumping into the center of that room just by closing that bale down a little bit.
Now, a little broken up on a two-story, you might be able to back that down and it'll be better. Because what are you going to do? Let me ask you this. Now that you know we aren't affecting the center of the room, are you going to do a lintel on the first floor? And especially around here. The window is chest height. Now, what are you going to do? Stand up. You stand up, you go like this, and you put water down there, and you hit the center of the room, and you hit all the contents right there. This is not something to do on a first floor. This lintel, this idea, is a second floor, okay? All right, now what we're gonna move to air entrainment. So, what do you want, Ray? I can't hear him, what's he saying?
I'll pass it.
Yeah, we need a translator. With a half bale, Ray?
Whole thing.
Alright.
And then start to close it down slowly and keep it clear. Who else wants to flow some water? Hawaii, man. You came all the way from Hawaii. Let's get you some water.
Thank you.
Everybody will have some turns. All right. You're going to do the thing that kills us all. You're gonna make Ray's day. You're going to push fire.
Push fire?
All right, so here, back up. Let's get the hose backed up a little bit. Just for demonstrative purposes, we're going to show. All right. So, what you're going to do is you're going to start with just, it doesn't matter the angle, just start with it in there. Then start moving it around.
Okay?
Yep. And then once you move it around, now everybody pay attention to these streamers over there, okay? When he first starts putting water in again, you might see him go a little bit just for the fact that air in equals air out, we can't replicate a fire. When he starts moving it around, you're going to see that change. They're going to come out a little bit more. Then we're gonna open it up to fog and he's gonna keep it just right there. Then he's going to do fog and he's going to move it around. You're going to see those things pegged out. If anybody wants to go stand over there, they're more than welcome to. All right, go ahead and start.
So, a little bit of movement, but not a lot. Now, look at the change in that, right? Just by moving that around a little bit. Right there, perfect. Yep. Now look at how much that changed those, right? Now look how much that changed. So how can you push fire? This is how you push fire, okay?
This fog nozzle is bringing a lot of air and not a lot of cooling with it, and that is where we start pushing fire. Moving it around like that, even a straight stream, smooth bore, you're going to move more air than you'd like to. So, I know when transitional tack was coming out, they were like, you keep it straight, don't move it, nothing. You can move it around a little bit, but as you saw, when you start trying to move it around more than you should, you're breaking the stream up and you're bringing air with it. That's what we don't want. Anybody got any questions? Did this kind of show you where your water goes and how air is moved from outside? All right. Well, if we'd like, we can transition into the interior, and we'll go over interior stuff. Sound good? All right.